In this video, I'll show you how the hidden button placket can be sewn. As you can see, this method will give you a nice and neat placket. It's a very easy method and can be used for lightweight fabrics. A hidden button placket is a great addition to a short dress or a blouse. By hiding completely from view, it creates a discreet fastening that can be placed anywhere on the garment without disrupting the line of the pattern. Before you cut a right hand front piece, you need to measure and draw a few mark lines. Here you can see the scheme of distance between lines. You can pause the video and copy this down. So first line is my center line. Then my first fold line is 1.5 centimeters away. 3 centimeters here, 3 centimeters, and 3 centimeters. And last is 0.5 centimeters. Once you have all these lines on your front piece, you need to make basic basts along the first fold line. Here and here, and the second line is 6 centimeters away from your first fold line. Make the basts as straight as possible, as you will make folds based on these lines. And on a second line from your first fold line, your second fold line, 6 centimeters away. Same here. Now we need to apply interfacing. Interfacing is 3.5 centimeters wide, and the length depends on your garment length. Line up interfacing to the second fold line. Trim any excess interfacing. The interfacing is 3.5 centimeters wide. Now, fold the placket along the fold lines. And press it. And then, along the first fold line. and press it. And now, fold your placket in half, like this, or along the crease line. Make sure that the edges of fold lines are lined up, and press out. Don't fold 0.5 centimeters line. Leave it for now. Yes, you can see I didn't touch my 0.5 centimeters line. You need to fold the placket along the first fold line. Right side to right side. Pin in place. And measure your seam allowance from the bottom edge. In my case, it's 1.5 centimeters. This point is very important because at this point I will need to stop stitching at crease line. I do a straight stitch from the fold to the crease line. Now, fold along the second fold line, again right side to right side, measure your seam allowance from the bottom edge. Seam allowance marks on both sides have to match. I'm measuring 0.5 centimeters from the edge, side edge. Remember, that's our last line from the edge. We need to make a straight stitch from the fold to the 0.5 centimeters line mark. Do a straight stitch from the fold and stop at the 0.5 centimeters line mark. You should get a continuous straight seam. If everything looks good, clip the corners. You need to make an incision at 45 degree angle to the seam from the garment side. And cut seam allowances, leaving 3-4 millimeters. Turn the placket right side out and press. Now we can do the hemming. Because my seam allowance is 1.5 centimeters, I am making 2 folds, 7 millimeters each. Now, make long and short basts along the crease line. question. You can do a straight stitch. I do my hem first. Straight stitch close to folded edge. And then straight stitch along crease line. Remove basting. And press. You can secure the bottom of the placket using blind hem stitch or a straight stitch on your sewing machine. For this type of placket, the buttonholes should be vertical. And that's it! Your placket is done! Thank you for watching.